Hey guys, in this video, I'm going to do this linear algebra proof. It says let A and B be two n by n matrices. Suppose that B is skew symmetric. Prove that A times B times A transpose is also skew symmetric. So this is a short proof that I had to do in my linear algebra midterm. It's pretty straightforward. You just have to know what a skew symmetric matrix is, the definition of that, and also some basic like matrix properties. So let me first define what skew symmetric is in the proof, and we're going to use that definition later on to prove that A B A transpose is skew symmetric. So let A and B be two n by n matrices, and suppose B is skew symmetric, so I'm just rewriting what we were given. Then, by assumption, we can say that B transpose is equal to negative B. And you can think of this as a scalar, so you can think of that as negative 1 times B, but it's basically going to be negative the values of the matrix B. So that is the definition of skew symmetric. So we can assume that this is true by the assumptions that were given in the proof. Then I said because square matrices of n by n size can be multiplied to produce another n by n matrix, and the transpose of an n by n matrix is still n by n, ABA transpose is a valid matrix. So let me write all that down. I was just very explicit because it was a midterm problem. So this is kind of like just writing out things that are kind of obvious that you can multiply an n by n matrix, and just saying explicitly that ABA transpose is a valid matrix, although we're kind of given that it is. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the transpose of what we're trying to prove is symmetric and get that to be equal to negative ABA transpose. So if ABA transpose is equal to negative ABA transpose, then it falls in line with the definition of being skew symmetric, and therefore we are done with the proof. So I'm going to say ABA transpose. And so for this step, this is what I was saying about knowing certain matrix properties because the order when multiplying or taking transpose does matter. So A times B matrices is not the same as B times A. And similarly for transpose, you kind of go in reverse. So ABA transpose is equal to A transpose times B transpose times A transpose. So that is equal to A, B transpose, A transpose. We are given that B is skew symmetric, so we have already said that B transpose is equal to negative B. So let's go ahead and plug that in for B transpose. So we're given that, and then on the side, I said we know that from the definition of skew symmetric. And then I said, let's think about this as a scalar. So negative 1 times B A transpose. If we think of it as a scalar, then we can move scalars when we're multiplying with matrices. So that's going to be equal to either negative 1 or just negative A times B times A transpose. So thus we have proven that ABA transpose of that is equal to negative ABA transpose. So to finish the proof, we can say thus by definition, ABA transpose is skew symmetric when B is skew symmetric. And we are done with this problem.